Well, hello there. It's your friendly neighborhood dad RPG, back here today to bring you the next episode in the history series. Whose life and potential death will we be diving deep into today? Donnie? Nah. Kinsey? Nah. Mr. Saints Godzilla? Nope. Today, we embark on the journey of none other than Benjamin King, or as he likes to call himself,
Benjamin Motherfucking King.
Because on this fine day, as you sit there helplessly in quarantine, I bring you the history of Ben King.
What we need is for you to shut the fuck up. You feel me?
Yeah.
What?
Yes, Mr. King.
I'll have Monroe put some pressure on the Saints. While they're distracted, it should be easy to take back what's ours. Everything else is business as usual. Understood? Now, this meeting is over.
In Saints Row, Benjamin King is the founder and the leader of the Vice Kings, one of the three enemy gangs. The Vice Kings have been active in Stillwater since the 70s, where King formed the gang alongside his best friend Julius to counter the Carnales' encroachment on the neighborhood of Sunnyvale. After King grew accustomed to power and refused to give it up, Julius retired to Saints Row, where King expanded his criminal empire.
Looking good, Ben.
Been a long time, Jules.
Sorry about Anthony.
That was business. Let it go.
By the events of Saints Row 1, the Vice King's presence is found heavily in the northern side of Stillwater. Under King, the Vice Kings control prostitution and gambling rings. They also hold numerous protection rackets and have turned their attention to more legitimate business ventures, such as the music industry's Kingdom Come Records.
Running a little late today?
Hey now, you gotta look good to sound good.
Want me to let him know you're in?
Would you do that for me?
She's here, Mr. Williams.
In the 1970s, childhood friends Benjamin King and Julius Little formed the Vice Kings to fight against the Los Carnales.
It's not the Los Carnales, it's just the Carnales.
The Carnales. Sorry, Dex. Who had swept through the neighborhood of Sunnyvale, demanding protection fees, pushing drugs, and bringing gang warfare to the streets. King organized the kids of Sunnyvale to stand up for themselves, and fueled by their desire to take back their neighborhood, the Vice Kings surged. Sunnyvale was liberated from the Carnales in a matter of days, but King, who had grown accustomed to power, continued his battle with the Carnales for control over the rest of Stillwater. Julius, unhappy with his friend's decision, decided to retire and move to Saints Row. King increased his gang's influence and income and decided to focus on legitimate business ventures instead of his criminal empire. This allowed the Carnales to regain their strength and a new gang, the Westside Rollers, soon formed. The three gangs fought against each other, but once the violence spilled into Saints Row, Julius was forced to follow King's footsteps and thus started the Third Street Saints, an attempt to calm down all the other gangs in the city. As King cultivated his gang, he employed Anthony Green, an old friend from back in the day, as his enforcer, and Warren Williams, a second-rate rapper turned third-rate gangster, to run Kingdom Come Records, the Vice King's record label. Tanya Winters, once nothing more than a small-time hooker, managed to be put in charge of the Vice King's brothel at the Raikens Hotel due to her relationship with Green.
Every day that bitch gets driven to the construction site in a limo, then sneaks off to get a freak on with Warren before she goes back home to Tony. While she's busy sucking cock, you deal with the chauffeur and take his place.
During this time, Chief Monroe had an undercover officer infiltrate the Third Street Saints. During the officer's preliminary report on the four gangs, he noted how Monroe doesn't want him investigating the Vice Kings any further, hinting at King's close relationship with the Stillwater Police Department. King first becomes aware of the Third Street Saints after they destroy the Kingdom Come Records building and apparently kill Aisha, causing millions of dollars in loss of revenue. King remains completely calm as he is informed of the incident, much to the dismay of his Lieutenant Warren Williams. After then being informed by Tanya Winters of the Third Street Saints' seizure of Prawn Court, King states that he will call in a few favors and have Kingdom Come Records rebuilt, and have Chief of Police Richard Monroe put pressure on the Saints, allowing the Vice Kings to take back their territory. The Third Street Saints fight back, and eventually head to an abandoned police station to kill Tanya. There, Johnny Gad and the play are ambushed by Anthony Green, who reveals that it was a trap devised by King.
Yeah, Tanya, shut the fuck up.
I thought I told you to be quiet.
I got shitty hearing.
Now you got a shitty leg.
They capture Gab, but the play escapes. An eager Warren Williams insists on taking further action, but King is currently content with Julius' lieutenant captured and the police out for the Saints. After Green is killed and Gad is rescued, Gad and the playa dress up as Vice Kings and cause chaos downtown, destroying the pride of Stillwater. Furthermore, they kill the policeman on King's payroll and destroy the Kingdom Come Records building again, staining King's relationship with Alderman Richard Hughes and Chief Monroe. Warren Williams, who is upset with King's refusal to get into drug dealing and who now believes King is being selfish, stages a coup with Tanya Winters and the other disloyal gang members. Ben King flees and requests help from Julius. The playa soon arrives under orders from Julius and rescues him, and together they go to the Saints headquarters, leaving Warren for dead along the way. After a discussion with his old friend Julius, Ben King accepts to walk away from Stillwater, but only once he's dealt with Tanya, who has now taken control over what remains of the Vice Kings. The playa and King lure several remaining gang members to the police ambush points, paving the way to Tanya. When playing this mission, you'll hear Ben King mention that playa should have joined the Vice Kings instead of the Saints, believing that they too could have owned the city.
Way to go, son. It's a shame Julius found you first. We could have owned this town.
Finally, alongside the playa and Johnny Gat, King heads to his old penthouse to finish off Tanya. After getting the codes to the elevator from Stefan,
Stefan knows about fashion, not about gangs.
The three fight their way through the remnants of the Vice Kings, and King personally kills Tanya, sending her plummeting to her death from the office. Outside the penthouse, Ben King gives the playas the keys to the building and walks away.
You did good in this, son. Here. I don't think I'll be needing these anymore.
Later, as Benjamin King prepares to board a private jet and leave the city, he briefly glimpses at an old photo of himself and Julius in the early days. Ben King then goes off to do gay porn for 8 years straight. Okay, no, he doesn't do that. And you might think this is the end of the Benjamin King story, but it's actually not, because now it's time for Saints Row 4. In Saints Row 4, Ben King returns, once again working for the Third Street Saints. In the 5 years between the two games, he has written Regicide, The Rise and Fall of the Vice Kings, a novel based on the events of Saints Row that has been adapted to a movie. After the events of Saints Row the Third, King helps the playa become elected as the President of the United States, with King becoming Chief of Staff. When the aliens in invade, King and Pierce are among those who are abducted. King is placed in his own virtual simulation, where he experiences the betrayal of Anthony and Tanya and being killed by them over and over again. When the playa arrives to rescue King, they first kill Anthony, but Tanya escapes into the virtual steelport. The playa then inform their plan to reunite the Saints and kill Zinyak. King is part of several story missions. First, when he is saved from the simulation, which unlocks him as a homie and also makes him a crew member of the ship. There's the loyalty mission with Tanya. And later on, the playa escorts King along with Pierce Washington, defending them from the Zim in a similar way to the Heli Assault activity. In the grand finale, King is an option in either of the three missions. He is teamed up alongside Johnny Gat. And if selected for the grand finale part 2, friendly Vice Kings arrive to assist him. It kinda smells like shit in here, doesn't it? Actually, wait, what is this? Oh my god, what is that? It tastes like
your fun facts.
King is one of the only two enemy gang leaders not killed in the series, along with Matt Miller, both of whom later work alongside the playa. During the Battlefield promotion cutscene, King looks at an old photograph of him and Julius. The photo of Julius and King is based in 1974. The picture looks to be taken at the Saints Row Church before it was trashed with graffiti and scum. Both are wearing their respective gang colors, although their taste in clothing may merely have served as an inspiration during the later formation of their respective gangs. In Saints Row 2, after rescuing Johnny Gat from the court, he mentions that King wrote an autobiography, referencing King's book, Regicide. In the mission where the playa kills Julius, the playa tells Julius that he should have dropped his flags and wrote a book like King did. In Saints Row 4, Benjamin King is voiced by Terry Crews, while in Saints Row 1, he was voiced by Michael Clark Duncan. After completing his loyalty mission, King Me, in Saints Row 4, King's virtual appearance is changed to resemble Morpheus from The Matrix. Ben King's romance is the only one on the ship that the playa does not have sex with. Instead, he asks King to sign a copy of his book. Ben King has a sister named Angela, who is never seen throughout the Saints Row series, but is mentioned by a paramedic in Saints Row 1, and alluded to twice in Saints Row 4. When talked to on the ship after he is saved, King may say, "If only Angela could see me now. My sister would never believe any of this." Julius Little's third audio log elaborates on her fate as well. He states how he felt few regrets.
"I don't regret much. You make your choices, you live with them. But if I could take anything back, it would be the way things ended up with Angela.
It was all fun and games for her. She wanted to be just like Benjamin. I shouldn't have let her get in so deep.
But yeah, there you have it, the history of Benjamin King. Glad you could stick around for another episode in this series. And feel free to comment who you'd like to see next. I have a feeling I may know who you want to see. Anyway, I made a Discord server, so you should definitely click the link in the pinned comment and come talk to me about your day. And feel free to follow me on Twitter if you'd like to see my pathetic attempts at making memes. I hope you are happy and healthy. Always remember to stay sexy. And this has been your boy, RPG, saying peace out.